Okay, so inspired by 20 questions, let's try to write down exactly what it is that you did in going through your 20 questions to get your answer to discover Michael Jackson was the person I was thinking about. So what was the very first thing you did?
I tried to imagine a bunch of possible answers that you could be, you know, could have in mind, and I tried to think of a question that would help separate them into two roughly equal chunks.
Okay, so what's a way of putting that in the language that we've been using for supervised learning and classification so far?
Oh, I see. So if I had known in advance, here's 200 things that you might ask me about, mm-hmm. And what their attribute values are, what would be a question that would split that set in half? Right. So if instead of just imagining a bunch of things, if I actually had a list, which I do in the case of a training set.
All right. So the first thing you did is you picked the best attributes that you could think of. And by the way, you said something very particular here. You've actually defined what best is. You said that best is the same thing as splitting things roughly in half. So let's revisit that in a moment. Okay. So the first thing you did is you picked the best attribute. You asked a question about it, and then depending upon the answer, you went and picked another attribute, right? Does that seem fair?
Yeah.
Okay. So if we think about decision trees, a way of talking about that is that you follow the path of the answer, and then lather, rinse, and repeat. Right? You went back and picked the best attribute, asked a question, follow the answer path, so on and so on, and you kept doing that until what?
Until I narrowed the space of possibilities to, in this case, just one item.
Right, so until you got to the answer, right? And that is an algorithm. So you pick the best attribute, and you actually define what best attribute was. You wanted to pick one that would somehow eliminate at least half of the things that you might worry about and keep the other half in play. You ask the specific question, you follow the path to that, and then you went back and you picked another attribute and so on and so forth until you got an answer that you wanted to. That's an algorithm, and that's an algorithm that we might use to actually build a decision tree. And the only difference between what you did and what you would do with learning a decision tree is that since you don't know in advance what the answer actually is going to be, because you don't know what specific object I might be thinking of, you have to actually follow all possible paths at each time and think of all possible best next attributes until you completely can answer any question. Does that make sense?
I see. So, right. So instead of just playing the game interactively, I kind of imagine all possible ways it could go and build that whole flowchart, the whole tree.
Right. So let's see if we can do that with some pictures. And I actually want to decide whether I really believe your definition of best. Okay?
Sure.
All right, so let's do that.